During his tour of the Acholi sub-region, the president received shocking revelations and testimonies from the locals on how the wealth creation campaign has been mismanaged. The president on Wednesday met a group of local leaders from Acholi led by the Gulu Resident City Commissioner Jane Francis Amongin Okili to follow up on complaints made in February. The leaders included local council chairpersons, councillors, women and youth leaders, and elders. The State House Anti-Corruption Unit head Brigadier General Henry Isoke also attended the meeting. Adokrach Dorin, a farmer from Onyama sub-county, Gulu district, told the president that the parish development model is good but has been mismanaged. She said in her area, people were called to the sub-county instead of the parish, and community development officers collected 10,000 shillings from the beneficiaries to get registered in the savings and credit cooperative organizations and get certificates.
Paris model meet a group, that don't believe group.
All this was done because they were told the parish development model needs people to be in the group.
Eh, Doc Bene, Miru Nong certificate. Mano Aki, sub county, and dodging. Kadon calls, met district, but and dodging.
The certificate should be endorsed by the CDO and also endorsed by the cow.
Eh, Tidong, Merkin, Miru Yab account, Machado group.
Then, as a group, you should open an account.
Opio Ronald Zola from Awach sub-county in Gulu district said many of the circles in Awach that registered their enterprises up to now have not received the money. He faulted the extension workers for delaying the process.
People even from the center, before the programs reach the down people, there are already some setbacks from the center with connivance even people at the district level. So that even when the program should really be meaningful to the people down, it doesn't succeed.
Alex Odong Okoya, the LC2 chairperson of Liberian Ward in Laro in Gulu City, said in his area, the Parish Development Model Secretariat rushed the enrollment of beneficiaries by giving them a very short time of 3 days to enroll. He says very few people were registered and many, especially the poor, were left out.
Problem is what I told you, that the few were found at home.
That's why
they narrow to 30 people only per enterprise. The many are left out.
President Museveni asked the State House Anti-Corruption Unit head Brigadier Isoke to follow up on the matters raised for appropriate action.
To appoint new people will cause more confusion. I think we should emphasize this people-based power, and where the people best are the ones who are engaged in the wealth creation. Not anybody is the one who is a manager. No. I am a farmer. I am a member of the circle.
About corruption, President Museveni said the National Resistance Movement government will not fail to bring to book all those involved in messing up the parish development model, in which the government has put many resources to get people out of poverty.
Because if you say, I get new people, you are now the... It will be like getting new parish chiefs. Or getting... Because all those people are there, the DSOs are there. You wonder why DSO doesn't report all this corruption. When I came to Acholi, I didn't get a report from DSO or from RISO or from PISO. They're all there. GISO, I didn't get a report that people are charging membership fee for the circles.
President Museveni also thanked the leaders for doing a good job and enabling him to structure the method which the NRM put in place to work, unlike in the past. He said the parish development model is meant to get everyone involved in wealth creation without any pay.
You who want to engage in wealth creation, join without paying anything. You only come because you want to be part of the wealth creation. This money belongs to the whole circle of the parish. The wealth creators, the ones of bananas, the ones of coffee, all of you, and you are the one to elect the leadership.
The Parish Development Model Project was launched by the president in February 2022 in Kibuku District, with the parish as the lowest administrative and operational hub for delivering services closer to the people and hence fostering local economic development.